Hey makers, it's time for a Makery tip. Let's learn how to convert images from Cricut, Word, or a picture file into a vector so you can cut them on the laser like this. To make a vector, we'll use a feature called Image Trace in Adobe Illustrator. Let's start with Cricut. First, we'll have to make a plain white background. Second, we make the image as big as possible on the screen. And third, we'll take a screenshot. First, to make a plain white background in Cricut, we have to turn off the grid in Settings. Second, click and drag to make our image as large as possible without cutting it off. Third, take a screenshot by pressing Shift, Windows, S on the keyboard, and then use the mouse to click and drag a box around your image. Our screenshot is now copied to the clipboard, and we just have to paste it into Illustrator. Now let's go to Illustrator and paste it with the keyboard shortcut Control-V. Now it's time to convert it into a vector image with Image Trace. Step 1, click on the image and then click Image Trace. Choose a preset from the dropdown. Usually black and white logo works well. And the image didn't change very much, which is good. So let's click Expand to finish converting. Step 2, change the fill to white and the stroke to black. The fill is the inside of the image, and the stroke is the outline. Click this black and white button here. This should turn the image into just an outline. If it didn't work, the image probably wasn't selected. Just click on your image and then try again. Step 3, delete the bounding box. Click the white arrow tool. Click the white background to deselect your image. Click on the big rectangle that surrounds your image. This is called the bounding box, and after you click on it, press Delete on the keyboard 2 or 3 times until it's completely gone. And we're done. Let's press Control-P on the keyboard to send it to the laser. And let's see how this turns out. Let's try another example, this time with Microsoft Word. After we type out our text, we just follow the same steps as before. 1, get a plain white background. 2, make it as big as possible on the screen. And 3, take a screenshot. Now paste it into Illustrator so we can convert it to a vector. Step 1, click on the image, and then click Image Trace. This time I'll try the Silhouettes preset. And Silhouettes changed my image just a little bit, so I'll try Black and White logo again. That's better. Click Expand to finish converting. Step 2, change the fill to white and the stroke to black. Again, we click this black and white button over here. Step 3, delete the bounding box. Great. All right, Control-P to print. Now, if you're already experienced with Illustrator, you may be thinking to yourself, there's a better way to do that. And you're right, but this video is not for you. If you're not an Illustrator expert, this is a fast and simple method. If you know a better one, please put it in the comments below. Let's do one last example. This one will be a little bit more complicated. What if we take a color image and try to convert that to a vector? I've got this rocket ship I downloaded for free. I can just drag and drop it into Illustrator. I'll resize it so it fits on the artboard. And then we'll do Image Trace again, just like we did before. click on the image, and then click Image Trace. And let's try out some different presets to see which one gives us the simplest looking image. Black and white logo, that looks good. I wonder if silhouettes is better. About the same. What about line art? Nope, no, definitely not that. I think black and white logo looks best. Click expand to finish converting. And let's pause here because this is where it gets more complicated than before. If we zoom in and look closely, you'll see there are lots of vector lines. These blue lines with the little pink text that say path, that's a vector line. There's one on the outside, one on the inside. And if we send this to the laser now, it will cut along all of these lines. And we only want to cut the outline. We need to delete all of these extra vector lines. So, click the white arrow and select each line that you don't want to cut and delete them all. Every image will work a little bit differently, so yours might need a little bit more work or maybe a little bit less. It's looking good now, so change the fill to white and the stroke to black. Control P to print, and we'll see how this one goes. And that's it for this Makery tip. We hope you find it helpful. Thanks for watching.